fired shot at him. If you look down through these limbs, that's what I had through. The spear deflects like an arrow. Whew, this is a lot harder than bow hunting. We're into the hunt on our second day. It's my second spear throw. What we're doing is trying to find a herd of hogs in the middle of the day. Normally they're bedded near water because of the heat here in South Texas. So we get where we can watch the hogs, and the minute I see one get up and come down to get a drink, I use this berm to go in and make my spear throw. That was a big boar. He's a little smarter than he used to be now.
Welcome to Relentless Pursuit. Today we will be hunting feral hogs on the Spike Box Ranch in Texas. I'll be hunting with Brent Van Hoven. Brent's bow hunting, and I'll be using a spear. Now, to kill a hog with a spear, you've got to get close. So we'll have some real action for you today. The key is to catch the hogs during midday hours while they're drinking at the creek bottoms. We'll be hunting along a dry creek bed where there's pockets of water. The hogs gather there often, and that's where we'll ambush them. Also, we'll be hunting the hogs in the fields near the cattle. They're much like deer. In the morning and the evening, they come out in the fields to feed. We'll try to ambush one there, and hopefully Brent can get one with his bow. Now with my spear, I moved along the dry creek bottom looking for hogs. It had been some time, but we finally found a small herd.
Got a guaranteed one right in front of you right there.
The big boar was laying in the mud, wallowing, trying to keep cool. It looked like a no-brainer.
See?
But my first attempt was a bust. He smelled me, and off he went. The Spike Box Ranch has more wild hogs than any place I've ever seen. It seemed like everywhere you went, there were wild hogs. They were definitely a big problem for the ranch. If you like to bow hunt hogs, this place is the best.
Still.
Brent was having some trouble of his own, and after three failed attempts, we came across this wounded hog out in the field. Something had injured her, a fence line or possibly a coyote, so Brent decided it was time to dispatch the beast. Well, Brent's dispatching wasn't going too well either, and he was off to the races.
Okay, folks. Well, this ain't going too good. We're not killing much. I'm walking back to the truck. Clint's out there, Brent's out there chasing a wounded hog that must have got caught by a coyote or something, had him hurt that he thought he could run it down. Well, that didn't work out for him. And he's had a little trouble with his hog, so I'm just gonna have to, I guess I'm gonna have to take matters into my own hands.
Let him get a little closer before I attack.
Okay, here we go. I got one. Okay. Okay, Brent. I'll hold this one for you, and when you get back to the truck, you can make your mind up whether you want to shoot him or not. It's okay, buddy.
Release. This will bring you luck. Release him. Nice and easy.
Good coyote bait, boy.
There he goes. See you later, Luella.
I don't even ask how you caught that thing. I've been humbled like you wouldn't believe.
Not long after, I came upon a good-sized boar that was rooting along the dry creek bed. I moved in as close as I could without spooking the boar, all the while making sure the wind was in my face. As Brent stayed behind and filmed, I maneuvered into position for the throw. But like a rutting buck, the boar started off the other direction. So I came back out of the creek bottom and got up on his level. And finally, the big boar dropped into the creek bottom for a drink. This was my chance. While the big boar's vision was blocked, I slid in above him, hoping to catch sight of him where I could get a good throw. As I moved in, I finally saw the top edge of his back. The boar threw his head up, and I knew it was time to make my throw.
see him laying up here, but I know I got him good. A lot of blood on the spear. A lot of good blood. A lot of blood on the ground, as you can see. When I hit him, there was a lot coming out, so... The wind was perfect, but I got lucky because he went down in that drainage to get a little drink. So I hopped out of the drainage, got up above him. Perfect. Those other hogs were grunting and spooked him right as he got ready to leave. I could just see the top edge of his back. And it's drunk.
You're the man.
Welcome back to Relentless Pursuit. We hope you're enjoying today's show. If you're just joining us, I've speared a big hog, and we're about to track the beast. Despite the hit and the massive amount of blood that the hog had lost, he still managed to go over 400 yards. I could see him laying under a tree. Yes! Yesterday, after missing that monster boar, I was pretty dejected. I was thinking about picking up my bow and going back, but Brent talked me into one more day with a spear, and by golly, looky here. Wow, that was awesome. Stick and no string. Now this is the javelin I threw in college, and I kept this javelin. I've had it for 20 years, 18 years, I guess. My kid ran over it with his bicycle, bent the end of it a little bit, but outside of that, it's in pretty good shape. I cut the end off and put a spear on it. I told my coach in college that someday I'm gonna kill a deer with this spear. Well, it ended up being a hog. I'll send him a picture of the hog, so. Hainsey, wherever you are out there, if you're watching this, thanks. It finally paid off. I got my first wild hog with a spear. Made a big hole.
Alright.
Is that a left?
Why don't you put some feeling in it? I'm gonna look like a schmuck.
Okay, let's do it again. You're the tenth. You're the man.